right, folks, you see it here. The ringside physician has been called in. We might get a stoppage here to the main event at UFC 295. That cut is nasty.
It's a big cut, but this guy wants to fight. You can see it in his eyes. He wants to continue. You don't want to see a fight like this end due to a cut.
And I don't think the doctor does either. He is going to allow the fight to continue for however long. Man, that cut is bad, DC.
It's a bad cut, but it's about giving your fighter a chance, so they've got to work very quick to try to close it up enough that he can continue into the final round.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Well, UFC 295, a live event they will not soon forget, and as we arrive at this fifth and final round, the main event will continue. We'll see for how long.
He's going to need some magic, John. He was looked at by the ringside official, so he understands that he's on borrowed time, but he needs to go right now if he wants to become the champion.
Able to connect with a beautiful jab. Oh, punches in bunches as he lands another combination there. Really doing a nice job stringing his shots together.
He's doing a great job of stringing the shots together and also just mixing up the target and the attacks. Great job finding different places for his strikes to land.
Oh, is that a huge strike right there? I'm not sure how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job. Oh, nice body shot. Oh!
And his nose is bleeding now. Yes, looks as... Just over 3 minutes now to go in the fight. Oh, big knee! Back to the feet now.
Oh, big elbow.
Well, at this point, DC, I'm not sure... Oh! Total strikes here in the latter stages of this fight. He's really picked up the pace and landing far more strikes than he did in previous rounds. Well,
oh, he's stuck bad. He's got to grab him. He's got to recover. Body shots. Oh, back and forth we go.
His nose.
Oh. Alex Pineda has done it again.
Holy smokes.
All right, we send it inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 21 seconds of round number 5. Declaring the winner by knockout, Alex Poetan Pereira!
All right, so it is Alex Pineda by knockout. Get used to hearing that. One of the more powerful, explosive middleweights on the roster and really just getting going.
He's so good at what he does that if you stand with him, he can shut your lights out with one strike. The guy is fantastic.
Are you ready? Are you ready? And let's go.
Like it, the number one middleweight contender back in a championship setting, and we've talked about this a lot, but he made himself undeniable with this run back to contention. Now he tries to wrest away the gold.
That's not easy, John. It's not easy to make your way back because you have been there before, and maybe it didn't work out for you, but to stay positive, to have that steel trap of a mind that allows for you to rebuild yourself, makes you know when you do get back, you have a greater appreciation for the opportunity.
Ready to fight? Ready. Good.
So here is the future Hall of Famer and former UFC middleweight champion, Michael Bisping. Known primarily as a striker, but if he needs to go to the takedown, he is not afraid to do so. Has some jiu-jitsu skills as well. Prevailing wisdom, though, is that Michael Bisping is going to try to throw hands and kicks here in this matchup tonight. Oh, he didn't see that one coming. Beautiful combination up top. slips. Oh, and so now he lands another combination, so it's never just one shot. There's always two or three coming behind.
A lot of times people throw singular strikes. Not this gentleman. This man is stringing four, five, six in a row. What a great job.
Bisping's nose is bleeding now, so we'll see how he handles that adversity, but nothing ideal about it here in the middle of this fight. Both guys throwing potential fight enders here in the early going.
Jab hurt him a little bit. Big punch lands through the middle.
Well, this striker has come out swinging early, and you know his style is based on aggression, and largely it's worked out for him tonight. Bisping's cut on his nose is just poor.
looking at a champion. You're looking at a champion. You're looking at a champion. No, 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 no. I'm a leader. You're looking at a champion.
Straight to the championship. This is the voice in your head.
Oh yeah, let's do this. Okay, this is the voice I've got.
something to the stream?
I got something for you. You're looking at a future UFC champ.
Yeah.
Remember that.
Let's go.
All right, everybody. The two fighters are ready to go here at the Backyard Battles. In this corner, they've been making a lot of noise around here. Give it up to the kid from Davis MMA. And standing on the other side of the cage, we got the Backyard Brawl. Y'all ready for some action? Let's make some fucking noise! You ready to fight? Let's fight! See that.
That's Michael Chandler right here. I know exactly who this is. It's that social media sensation whose coach told him explicitly not to do backyard battles anymore. Am I right?
Come on, coach. I told you already. That was the last time I was going to sign up for that.
I know it's the last time. I know it's the last time because we're going to start training you for legit fights starting today.
Hold on. Did you just say legit fights?
Look at him. All excited. Like I'm doing you a favor. Tell you what. Don't thank me yet. You gotta take your training to a whole other level. So, go get changed, warm up, meet me by the bay.
Oh, you got it, coach.
All right. Hey, social media sensation. No high fives, okay? Get your ass changed, warm up, meet me by the bags. Jesus fucking kid. What are we gonna do? I don't know. There you are, the kid sensation. What's up? Listen, not gonna lie to you, that knockout was pretty impressive. Got some natural ability, but that backyard brawler was no defensive wizard, right? You can beat fighters like that just by throwing the same shit over and over. Against higher level opposition requires more skill, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go over some basics on the bag and get you warmed up.
Yes, sir.
Right.
All right.
Heavy bag time. Listen for my instructions. All right, let's go. Okay, now let's focus on hooks. Man,
and uppercuts now. Go. Punch sequences now. Here we go. Nice job. Keep going. All right, let's go. Overhands now. There we go. Nice strike. Okay, throw your strikes now. All right, time for something else. Let's go. Okay, throw some leg kicks. Okay, let's see some striking now. Now let's put some punches together. Nice strike. That'll keep him honest. All right, gonna hit some leather today. I'll call it out, you throw. Now, yes, keep that up. Nice work. Feel that? Shit burns, right? Now, you see how important it is to manage your stamina? If you just keep throwing nonstop, eventually your attacks will get slower and weaker. Now, bags don't hit back, sparring partners do. So keep that in mind while we work on some stuff in the octagon. Defense only today. That's the name of the game. And don't get hit. There we go. Now focus on blocking all attacks. Good, good. Moving on to the next one. Extend yourself. Okay, dodge all of his attacks. All right, good work. Next set. Hey, awesome job. Now let's move on. Now block everything. How your arms get beat up when you block a few shots in a row, right? That's when your opponent will start striking right through your block. When that happens, you gotta move your head, move your feet, get space, give your body and your arms time to recover.
You're right. I can't just cover up. Makes it hard to see shots coming in, too.
Right, but remember, evasive movements also drain your stamina. So, whatever it is, attack. Good, clean strikes today, all right? Let's do it. Okay, work on your slips now. Okay, now work on your hooks. Get in on that. Okay, clinch and give him no room. Hands up. back with your hands. Okay, now get into the clinch and control the position. Don't let him hold you in the clinch. Grind, grind, grind. I want to see block and move, okay? Block and move. Keep moving, okay? Keep watching. I want the chin down.
go. Nice work. Now you're learning.
Give me mine, 150 on the dash to the finish line. All the cameras on live, got me in the chat. It's crazy when they ain't got no idea what you've been through just to get to where you going. Fuck them. They out
there. Rider, rider, ride. Looking good. All right, bring it in. Yo, nice work in the fight the other night, okay? But you were fortunate your opponent wasn't a big threat on the ground because, let's face it, we didn't spend much time in there. All right, that's good, that's good. The goal is... stay on your feet. Use your legs, keep your head high, and maintain a strong base. Let's go. You know better. Let's step it up now.
Game the way they want me to, they tell me take a left, I take a right. I'm not the one to pick a fight, but try and bully me.
Nice. Good. All right, buddy. We're gonna time the shoot and get the takedown. Okay. Good work.
In every class, never coming last. Jamie's on my back.
Ready to go? Are you ready? Let's go!